Hey everyone, thanks for joining us. I'm Ariel from After Dark Gaming, here with the Mortal Kombat 9 winner of Revelations, Michaelangelo, taking it with Cabal. Michaelangelo, congratulations on a great win, sir. Michaelangelo actually had to come back and fight out of losers to beat online Tony twice, 3 out of 5, which is pretty impressive, I have to say, especially with the mirror match. So I wanted to ask you, first thing, I know with the patch coming out so late, suddenly, right before the tournament starting, what were your thoughts going in with the Cabal Infinite news?
Well, going in, like, I was excited the patch was removed. Like, I didn't care that I didn't really get practice with it. I was like, oh, how bad is he, or how much is it removed? Like, I had to test it out, but I still, no matter what, I wanted it to be removed before this, because, you know, I've been hearing a lot of people been saying that that's all I do, the Infinite, and that's how I win. But I mean, once it was removed, I was like, okay, you know, I could, let's see, I hope I prove myself, and I did, and I'm glad that I did, because, like, you know, I knew I didn't need the Infinite, but people were saying it, so I had to prove it. So yeah, and I knew if the patch wasn't here, and if I would have did well, it would have still been like, well, you used the Infinite.
Right.
I'm glad that it was removed before the tournament, because, you know, now it's like, well, it was removed and I still did good.
Well, some people are actually still saying, well, it's not patched quite enough, and it still looks like an Infinite. It seems like, what are your thoughts on that?
I mean, yeah, it's not an Infinite no more, but it is still pretty fast. I mean, it's one of those things that you should fully take it away just because people are complaining about it. You just gotta try to get over it, but I mean, I guess if they really want to, like, if it's that bad, like, I wouldn't mind if it was patched even more. I wouldn't care. Like, I mean, he has a good zoning game. That's not all I do. You know, it's not, I mean, I do look out for it, but, you know, he has good mix-ups and stuff.
Oh, yeah, Cabal's got a lot of really good mix-ups. So we saw you using the ball and the flash ball comes out of his eyes and grind a lot. And you were zoning really, really well. I know both of you guys have a very similar but different play style. I mean, you like to zone a lot more and then switch it up and get in close and mix it up with the
Mad Dash run. Yeah, and I was like, wow, like, I never really seen online Tony how he plays Cabal. I just, like, kind of invented that stuff on my own, and I don't think he ever watched my matches. And I think we invented, like, almost the same strategy with Cabal, and it was, like, pretty cool. I was like, wow, I'm seeing him today on the stream when he beat me and stuff. And I sat down and I was watching him. I was like, wow, he's using, like, everything I'm using, so I know I'm playing him at a good high level. You know, I'm doing everything right. And, you know, even if they're saying, oh, well, you got first because of Cabal, well, it was a Cabal mirror, like, I didn't really have trouble going. Like, Tony beat me the first, and he sent me to losers. He didn't have trouble with the run cancel and stuff. And when I beat Tony, it's like showing, well, I didn't have trouble with it. You know, you could beat it. It's just, you know, you just got to practice, you know. Instead of complaining, just practice it. You know, go in the lab, practice.
That's what I say. I tell people, yeah. If you got time to sit there and troll, and do all stuff and complain about it.
Yeah, complain and go to the creators and stuff.
Yeah, go all.
Just practice.
Practice.
Yeah. It's all
in the lab. If you're getting spammed and you don't know how to deal with it, well, hey, go in the lab. Find another character or something like that. And Mortal Kombat's a lot about matchups, too.
Yeah, it is a lot about matchups. But, you know, if there's a hard matchup. Like, if I have a hard matchup, I don't really try to go with another character. I just try to just play it as best I can. I did play Eris Ermac. I went with Ermac over there, but I was like, wow, this is just... I thought it would be a better match for me. I was like, with Cabal, I can't really zone him because he has that shake, right. Smoke shake. So I was like, oh man, I'm just going to go with Ermac. But he knew how to play that match really well, and I was like, I'll just go with Cabal, my team guy, and see what happens. And I flushed it out.
Yeah, and I don't think Eris used to follow up against you, too. Usually after his combo, he would teleport and get right there while you were down to get close. He was keeping away as far as possible.
Yeah, like, that's one thing, like, people complain about the up-on and stuff. Really, like, I wouldn't care if it was nerfed again or if it stayed, because, like, I played as Kano, and I was more happy that he chose Kano to smoke and stayed with smoke, because I was like, oh, even Kano, like, I went to the lab and worked on, like, how to counter this up ball and stuff, so, you know, I didn't really just complain about it. I was like, well, I'm just going to see what can I do against him. I mean, he didn't really know what to do against me. Like, I was just stuffing everything he had, so.
Hey, you played really, really, really well. Well, congratulations. And any words to everybody at home?
Shout out to all my friends back at home for helping me practice. Shout Dallas to Starbase, the NorCal scene, if you want to go there and practice. And then shout-outs to just all the MK players, all the MK fans that just want to get good and And shout-outs, especially shout-outs to the haters, because it drives me to want to just practice more and prove everyone wrong. So shout-outs to them, too.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.